At this point, I thought I'd give Representative Sortsen a chance to talk a little bit about what you saw last night. Sure. This is your community, so you kind of give a unique perspective.
Yeah. It was one of those things where I was painting in a church in Fontenelle and kind of keeping an eye on the weather and keeping on the phone with my wife, and she told me it was getting pretty bad over here and started getting calls from some friends and family, and so I kind of chased the tornado into town and out of town and just pulled into the bank parking lot. And you know, there's incredible common sense in this community, just incredible resolve. People were already getting to work, clearing debris out of the roads. I mean, everybody that brought a skid loader in, thank you a million. I mean, that was a way to clear the streets and make it accessible for emergency personnel. Everybody became little makeshift ambulances. We pulled a guy from the rubble and put him on a little makeshift stretcher that we made, threw him in the back of a truck of a guy that isn't even from Iowa. And we just made our way to the lumber yard, which was the makeshift hospital. And so, you know, as I toured around with the governor, I told her, I kind of wish you were here last night, because I mean, we've already done so well. I mean, this community has already done so well at just cleaning up the streets and getting to work on rebuilding. You know, we may be turning volunteers away for now, but I know news and things like this are easy to forget. Please don't forget about us. Please continue to send volunteers and be at the ready, because we will need just hands on deck and chainsaws and whatever we need to, you know, heavy duty trucks to get this stuff out of here and get started on the rebuild. So that's
And that is just for today on the volunteers. So thank you for making sure that we clarified that. It's just, we just need to stabilize some of the debris and what's taken place.